dealing with any deceased citizens, I will properly dispose of their name. Mm-hmm. And what you should definitely not do is stand there gawping. You don't want to draw a crowd, and it's not helpful to stare at their body. Down. Don't just leave the body there and move on. And if you see a lot of people walking past someone in the middle of the street, simply trust that they've already realized there's nothing further they can do for that person. Just pretend that the person in the street is not there. And sooner or later they won't be. Take it from me, Uncle Jack. What's done is done, and it's best if we all move on. You'll be glad you did. Now, it's time for our daily recreational activity, to show where you're the star. Come on, everyone. It's time for everyone to get out of the street and find a telly to watch. This game is so much more fun with all of your friends and fellow citizens. Today is a very special episode of our favorite Simon Says. Have you ever wondered if you're ready to meet the Germans ever did? Would you know how to defend yourself against the marauding boss? Let's play Simon Says. Yeah, you say Simon Says. You all know the rules, don't you? I'm going to tell you to do something. And if I don't say Simon Says, you do. If I do say Simon Says, yes, you do do it. All right. Is everybody ready? Do that. Are you ready? Oh, you are. Yes, that's the Wellington Wells spirit. Everybody give him a hand. Good. No. Say Simon Says. All right then. Now what I want everyone to get themselves a weapon. Cricket, bat, or crowbar, anything like that. And if all you have is a banana, well, that's fine. And if you do have a banana, just drop it here at the station and I'll spot you for Christmas. It's like me, you nut.
Good.
Simon says, raise your weapon. Simon says, swing right. Simon says, swing left. Simon says, swing right. Ha-ha, yes. I can see I already got a few people out there. You swung left, then you're out. The German got you. Fall to the ground, eviscerated. I'm just joking. You can never be too careful. All right. Simon says, swing left. Simon says, swing right. Simon says, lunge. Simon says, carry. Lunge. Ah! Yes, you. You're out. Remember, the lunge is your finishing blow. Save it for enemies when your enemy's on his back foot. No matter what's up. Did you lunge? You were supposed to. I didn't say Simon said, see, I just said it in bits. Yes, so you and you, you're out. Simon says, you're out. Very good. You're all good.
Yes. Come on, give it to me. Simon says, give it to me. Yes, yes, very good.
Simon says, take a step forward. Simon says, take a step back. Simon says, swing right. Simon says, swing left. Simon says, finishing blow. Step back. Simon says, shout. Yes. Simon says, raise your weapon. Simon says, have fun. You're all doing brilliantly. Very good. Simon says, jump. Simon says, parry. Simon says, dodge. Simon says, lunge. Simon says, victory beat is wonderful. Captain says, swing left. Ha-ha. You see, Simon says. Simon says, don't do the next thing I say. Simon says, jump. Oh, what do I do? What do I do? What do I do? Simon says, run in circles. Simon says, shoot. Simon says, lunge. Lovely. Simon says, sing Rule Britannia. Rule Britannia, Britannia rules the waves. Britain never, never, never shall be slain. Simon says, swing right. Simon says, swing left. Simon says, swing right. Down. You there. Simon says, run along. Go on. Simon says, fall down. Simon says, get up. Simon says, roll over. Simon says, stand up. Brilliant. Simon says, do everything I do, I shout it, even if I don't say Simon says. Swing right. Swing left. Swing low. Swing chariot. Well, I'm afraid. Simon says, spin. Simon says, now the game is over. Simon says, I hope you all enjoyed yourself in that. I just did. We've come to the end of our time. Tune in again next time for another rousing daily recreational activity. Thank you all for playing. Three downers at the bottom of the sea. Not enough downers. Very good. We're starting off very strong today, aren't we? This one is from Briny Fishman of Collier's Lane. What's the difference between a downer and a trampoline? You take off your shoes before you jump on a trampoline. How true! How very true! You don't go to damaging every secret trampoline, do you? Very good indeed. This is from Mrs. Jemima Hughes of Coronation Avenue. If you see a drowning downer, what do you throw him?
Another one. The moral of the story, don't go watching man, at the end of our time. Tune in again tomorrow for another bedtime. Jack Worthing, have a lovely night.
And it's another fabulous day in Wellington Wells. The sun is up, the weather is overcast, and only slightly raining, with occasional patches of lovely sunshine. Wakey, wakey, everyone. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Good morning, dear friend. Good morning to you. Well, I hope you all had a lovely night's sleep with lovely dreams. It's shaping up to be a wonderful morning, and I think I can promise you that it's just going to get better all through the day. You'll forget things from time to time, so don't forget the most important things. Is it your tea? Is it your muesli? Is it bacon and eggs? Is it toast? Did you forget to butter your toast? No, don't be silly. It's your daily joy. Never forget to take your joy, and I guarantee your day will go swimming. So, let's take a look at today's schedule. What's going on in the village of Hamlin? Well, chatting and greeting and smiling and laughing, of course, and breakfast, lunch and dinner, and work, 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 work. That's green. I hope you'll all take a quick break for our daily recreational activity. Today, we will all gather around the telly for a rousing round of Simon Says. Well, I won't be gathering around the telly. I'll be in the telly. Just like every day, I'll be playing it with you. And then there'll be cake and prizes for all winners, and everyone's a winner, and everyone will be there. So don't miss it, or you're a rotten egg. But seriously, unless you have an awfully good reason, such as two broken legs, you'll be at 4 to 3 o'clock. Love your company. And now, the hot new song from our favorite band. love our gardens, don't we? And for the things in the room we call home, it looks like the unrenovated areas of Wellington Wells are abloom with wildflowers. But you can never be too careful. The garden district is abloom with mortal dangers as well. Hungry wastrels and depressing down as proud a land. And the municipal police simply do not have the resources to patrol places that no one lives. So, be sensible and stay on the painted road. It's there for your enjoyment and protection. But the painted road is all you know, and all you need to know. Now it's time for I Hear You, the show where Jack Worthy and me, Answers your letter to questions about our lives and all Wellington Wells. What is wrong? Richard Starkey of Biddleton Hall. Dear Uncle Jack, is it true there are blind albino mole people living beneath our fair city? That's what my friends say. I thought I saw one too, but I wasn't sure, as we all had a bit too much to drink. And my memory, of course, is a bit fuzzy. Dear Richard, of course there aren't mole people. This isn't London. There are no ancient catacombs or old bomb shelters underneath our streets. And of course the Wellington London is completely blocked up. Human beings have not suddenly grown claws to make their own tunnels through the dirt like crystals. What an imagination your friend has. Now, of course, there are these four benighted wastrels in the garden district. Easy enough to go there. Not to mention the unexploded bombs, the rusty shuts of metal and holes that you can fall into. And I don't need to tell you about how dangerous it is outside the wall. Think about going there. But you can be perfectly sure that absolutely no one is moving around underneath the pavement. Well, I'm glad that's settled. One is from John Lyon, then we'll go. Dear Jack. I guess he's the sort of fellow to cry uncle I, Mr. Lyon. Dear Jack, there's a stranger in my house who looks just like my wife. And she says she's my wife too. What has been done of my real wife and who did this to me? Your help is much appreciated in this matter. Well, it looks like Mr. Lyon has been experiencing one of these odd side effects of joy. It does happen from time to time. Of course, capgraph delusion. Unheard of. Mr. Lyon, if you're listening, go see a doctor. They may be able to adjust your dose or give you an analog. And listening here, so if you know Mr. Lyon, live on Bendel Road, do inform a nearby doctor. Mr. Lyon might need a visit. I'm sure everything will come out rosy. And remember, by the way, don't hesitate to go see your doctor if you need any medical attention. They fix up that cut right away. They always check your joy level and make sure that it's where it should be. Good. This is from Edwin Powell of Poitiers. Dear Mr. Worthing. Oh, let's be friends, shall we? Let's go to bed. Dear Uncle Jack, I was cleaning out my carriage, and they came up with a big pile of newspapers from the war. Yes, well, you can read the rest of the letter, because I know exactly what you should do. What do you do with a bunch of old newspapers? Well, it's the perfect thing to use to light a fire in your fireplace. The older and drier the paper, the better. I wouldn't recommend using it to wrap fish. First of all, because I haven't seen fish in years. And second, because you're not a fish shop. And third of all, the paper does get a bit crumbly, and you don't want that on your food. So just burn it all up in a cold night. Wonder if we want to quit while we're ahead. All right. We'll give it one more go, shall we? Dear Uncle I wasn't mistaken. It's from Susan Jane Talion of Chislehurst Vicarage. Dear Uncle Jack, I keep getting lost in my own neighborhood. I've lived there all my life, but lately it seems like they're moving the buildings around them. It's most disconcerting. I'm not old or anything, and I haven't been hit on the head, at least not that I remember. They're not actually moving the buildings, are they? But she are. Dear Susie, may I call you Susie? Dear Susie, I'm glad to say that you clearly are taking your joy. Joy in what helps us forget the past and move into the radiant future. Getting lost is just a mild side effect. Fortunately, there's an easy solution. Carry a map. In fact, carry one in each pocket. That way you don't have to remember which pocket your map is in. You know, I'm so delighted I can so easily help a listener. here we are. Yes, I'm afraid we've come to the end of our time. Tune in again tomorrow for more advice and news from our listeners and watchers. This is Jack Worthing saying cheerio and on with your day. See you soon.
But if the winter was hard, the summer was hard. Thank you. Ha, 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 ha.